Hi, welcome to the amazing Blue and Rolli self-care show. Hey Blue, how are you?
I'm doing really awesome.
Good. Hey, are you thirsty for knowledge today?
I'm ready to get hydrated on some knowledge, man.
Heck yes, we are going to have our water flowing today. So yes, you guessed it. We are going to talk about Blue's favorite thing ever, which is hydration. Hydration is so important, and we always are emphasizing it on this show, Blue especially, and it's because it's one of our body's six essential nutrients. But the crazy thing is we can't store a lot of water, right? We sweat it out, we pee it out, and sometimes our body absorbs it when it needs it. So there's just really no storage space, kind of like my house. I have very little storage space here to keep the water in our body.
About that, you know, I live in an RV currently, friend.
I know. I just say I live in an oversized tiny home. That's basically what I live in. So we need fluids to really hydrate and keep every single cell. And there's a ton of cells in our body, right? To you know, keep us happy and healthy. Do you know the percentage of the human body, like water, how much water makes up the human body?
Generally, you go with the rule of 50%, but some people are like 75%.
You are right. Yes, 50 to 75% of our human bodies are made up of water, which is bananas to me. We are just like fluidy, loosey-gooseys inside. And water does so many different things for our, systems, right? So obviously it's the basis of our blood. It's in our digestive juices. It's in our urine, our sweat or perspiration, if you want to be fancy. And it's also contained in the lean muscle, fat, and bones. So water is key for athletes. And our show caters to athletes. And I get asked a lot. I'm sure you get asked a lot. I'm a former athletic trainer. So we spent so much time on hydration and hydration, especially at practices and at competitions. And then if it's super hot, whether that's indoor facility is super hot, we know a lot of places that we all in our community practice don't have air conditioning. We do have some practices outside if you have good weather. And so we'll touch on that as well today. And so the biggest question people ask, right? How much water should I be drinking?
As much as your body needs for what you're doing. Okay.
Yes. So the easiest, I think, advice is what feels good to you, right? You know, people say, well, I was told you have to drink like 64 ounces of water a day. You know, there are some numbers and we'll throw those numbers out throughout the show, but honestly, just go with your instinct. And I can definitely tell a difference when I'm hydrated versus when I'm doing a really bad job at hydrating. You just feel different. Your head is a little bit foggier when you're dehydrated. You're more tired and things like that. But honestly, the amount depends on everybody's body size, your metabolism, the weather, which we talked about, the foods we eat and what our activity level is, right? So, you know, fruits and vegetables are full of water.
And vitamins and minerals. Oh my goodness.
I know.
Important.
Look at us two sciencing today. I love this. So, you know, it depends, right? So if you eat, you know, a bag of chips or something, that's not necessarily going to help rehydrate you. So it kind of just depends on what you're eating throughout the day, whether you're going to need more water or not. And again, a big myth too is when it's cold, people don't feel like they need to drink water. But if you're doing activity and you're not eating foods that are necessarily hydrating, then you definitely need to be drinking more fluids. So when you are kind of thinking about what your requirements for fluid are, you should definitely just feel what your general body needs, which we kind of talked about, and then the additional fluids that you'll need for whatever you're training to do.
So as she said, when it comes to water, it helps regulate a lot of our systems. So let's say, for instance, the digestive system. If you're not drinking enough water, the digestive enzymes cannot activate as optimally as they should be, okay? So we try to stick with the science behind most of everything. But in layman's terms, if you're not getting enough water, your system is not going to perform at its most optimal, like, value. Like, you're not going to get optimal performance out of your body. Because if you don't feed your body what it needs to be fed, vitamins, minerals, waters, whatever the case may be, your body's going to rebel. It's going to tell you, hey, something's wrong and I can't work. Matter of fact, I don't want to work. Okay? So that's not science. It just is the end result that ends up happening for a lot of people. And as athletes, we are always sticklers as body workers that you have to be hydrated. Have to be hydrated. You are demanding of your body more than its general performance. You are asking for not just optimum performance in every system, but you are asking for feats of the body to perform at a accelerated level. So therefore, you're breaking down cells. Your body's going to require more cells in order to build more muscle. So, I mean, coming from the standpoint of a body worker and an actual personal trainer, you have to fuel your body. And a key part of fueling your body is making sure you're hydrated properly. Water is key. There's sports drinks. A lot of them are full of a lot of sugar. But most of the time, sports drinks help with the minerals that we're missing, like electrolytes and stuff like that. Potassium, magnesium, sodium, some of your basics of that. One of my favorites is pickle juice. Have you ever tried pickle juice, Rolli?
I have. And actually, I know quite a few teammates and former teammates that keep a jar of pickle juice on the bench, or they also have mustard as well, which is a little funky.
Is utilized for cramps sometimes.
Yes, yes. Because of the salt in the mustard, right?
Is that right?
Yeah. So yes, the pickle juice, I like pickles. So I like all things kind of pickled. So pickle juice to me is actually quite delicious. And yes, that does work really well.
Brine. The brine is like key. It has everything you would need, enough sodium, as like vinegar, I believe, is in it, garlic.
Yes.
It depends on what the pickle, what they use to make that brine, but man, pickle juice is pretty tasty to me. They have like pickle juice popsicles. Now they have pickle juice beer. I don't know what that's about, but pickle. If you're ever at an event that I'm at, I usually have pickles. Probably don't want to share my pickles. Let's just be clear. But if you need one, might give you one. Okay.
Yes. And so talking about those sports drinks, you know, the sodium is what is lost through sweating, right? So that's where those sport drinks are going to be really, really important to come into play. And, you know, I am not a big sweater. I'm not a heavy sweater. I know plenty of people that you tap their derby helmet and it's just a deluge. I mean, it's crazy to me. I'll take my helmet off and my hair looks like I just got out of the salon, you know? I mean, it's just dry.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. It doesn't look good, but it's just dry. And so for me, I still make sure I hydrate, but I'm not losing as much as somebody who is an excessive sweater. And that's just their their body, their genes, you know, and that's just who they are, but they definitely need to make sure that they are properly hydrating. And, you know, you can definitely experience some serious issues if you let your body get to a dangerously low blood sodium level. And, you know, hopefully our community is smart enough and we have strong-will teammates that are constantly reminding everybody to hydrate, especially when it is super warm out, you know, on the track or if you're outside doing stuff. So the sports drinks are really beneficial, like I said, for an intense exercise longer than 60 minutes and those salty sweaters. It kind of sounds funny. Kind of sounds like my sweater is a bit salty, you know.
So, well, you know, I mean, you've probably witnessed it, you know, on the track when you have that one person where it's like, oh, dude, my eyes are kind of burning. It's salt.
It is. FYI.
And it, oh, may, yeah, it may be the body just trying to get rid of just a little bit of the extra that you've had. So if you had more water in your system, it would probably just flush straight through. But when you don't have enough water on your system, it sits in certain areas, especially the areas it secretes out of, which would be like the eyes, tears, or sweat, you know, all that salt's coming out with the water. And if there's not enough, like, to waterfall it down, it's gonna hit. Okay.
Yes. And I know that sometimes the sugary sports drinks can be hard on the stomach. So all you really need, if you are doing that intense exercise, it's extreme heat, or you are one of those more excessive sweaters, is just a few gulps every 15 to 20 minutes. That's all you need. You don't need to be, you know, down in the sports drinks, but just a few sips, you know, every 15 to 20 minutes is a good rule of thumb. So getting back to hydrating during exercise, and we're going to talk about what you should do before, during, and after. So you should always be well hydrated when you are doing any kind of activity. Alcohol will dehydrate you. So if you do choose to drink alcohol, just make sure that you're drinking lots and lots of water in between drinking the alcohol. That also helps with the hangover. A hangover really is just you being dehydrated. It's just a lot of signs and symptoms of dehydration. And so,
so I can tell a funny story. It's appropriate. Don't worry.
Go for it.
Okay, so the first time, because I don't drink often. Everybody who knows me knows I probably 3-4 times a year, usually during a special occasion. But the first time I ever got a hangover, I woke up in the morning and I told my friends, I just want ramen noodles and Gatorade. And they said, Blue, you're hungover. I'm like, I am? They're like, yeah, you need water. The reason why you want Gatorade is because you don't intake a lot of salt. So your body's telling you, ramen noodles, because you need some food. Put it in that stomach. And you need Gatorade, so you need to rehydrate. I'm like, oh. Confessions of a, like, beginner drinker.
Yeah. Join us every week for more Confessions with Blue. So, all right, let's get to some numbers here. And I'm a former athletic trainer, like I've mentioned. So I went to kind of my go-to resources, which is the NCAA.org and then the NATA, which stands for National Athletic Trainers Association, to get some really good footage. Oh, somebody on the chat said pickle juice is also a good hangover remedy. Yes, it is. Yes, for the same reasons. So we'll drop the links to those sites into the chat, and then you can see them there. But let's talk about this, and then we're going to actually look at a chart in just a few minutes that actually can tell you kind of if you're hydrated or not. So before exercise, like we said, you should be very well hydrated. You should be drinking about 16 to 24 ounces of water within 2 hours prior to the training. And then 10 to 20 minutes prior, you should actually drink a little bit more water. And I actually had a nutritionist one time tell me to, the first thing to do in the morning is to wake up and just drink a glass of water. And yes, one, it'll kind of help satiate you a little bit. That's a hard word to say. But it also, you know, kind of gives you a little bit of hydration kick to go on in the morning. Yeah.
Because they've already utilized all the water that you drank from the day before and the night before you went to sleep. Your body already utilized that water to try and, you know, flush through. But now you're about to drink. I always tell everybody, a glass of water first thing in the morning could be room temperature. Doesn't have to be cold. I probably would prefer room temperature versus cold or super hot. But your body automatically takes that and says, thank you. You know, thank you so much for acknowledging we needed this.
Yes. And so then when you're doing exercise, training, or competition, whatever's happening, it should be 6 to 12 ounces every 10 to 20 minutes. And, you know, are you really going to be kind of remembering how much water you're sipping and things like that? You know, it also kind of depends on how much you play and all these stuff. But just honestly, the good rule of thumb is just drink water. Right? You know, even if you're not thirsty and you're sitting on the bench or you know, you're taking a break. If you're doing some kind of, you know, exercise routine, just drink, just take some sips. You know, you can overhydrate, but it takes a lot to do that. So, you know, you're not going to hurt your body by, you know, just taking a few sips here and there every few minutes. And so then post exercise or, you know, games, practices, things like that. You really want to replace, and, you know, it's hard for most people, but the rule of thumb is you're supposed to weigh yourself before and after training. So if you're curious, you don't have to do it every time, but if you're curious and you remember and you have the ability to weigh yourself, this is, you know, you can kind of do the little test on yourself. So weigh yourself before you train and then weigh yourself after you train. And the rule of thumb is one for every pound lost in weight, you replace it with the 16 to 24 fluid ounces of water. And your total fluid should be consumed within 2 hours of finishing your training. But as long as you do it within 6 hours, and that's a big window, 6 hours, then you should be okay. If you don't have a scale to figure out, you know, the water and things like that, then again, just drink. Right, Blue?
Just drink water. It's all of you guys have these pretty little awesome looking containers. I do too. See, I got them all. Okay.
I got
shaker cups or whatever, your big old one. Cold or hot, you guys have these awesome looking containers. Put them to good use. Put some water in it. I can't tell you how many people come to my booth and just say, hey, can I have some of your gallon? Because I forgot to fill my water. It's my gallon. I don't want to share. And I've drank out of it. But I guess athletes come first, right? I'll just take care of them, but you should have water. And no, putting ice in your bottle, yes, it gets you somewhere. Putting ice in your bottle completely and then pouring Gatorade over it, that's not the equivalent of water.
No. Okay,
it's liquid, but anything other than water, your body's gonna probably process as like a nutrient. It's going to take it and try and feed it to something if it's not just pure water. And trust me, Gatorade is not just pure water. Does the job, not knocking it, does the job. But I would prefer that you drink water.
Yes. Okay? So what, how, like, why should we hydrate, right? What is the goal of hydrating? So as long as you're beginning your workouts in a very well hydrated state, you are going to already be in the right direction. Mm-hmm. And then maintaining that hydration is super important. It's going to maximize your performance and the ability to recover from the training or the competition is going to be so much better than if you're dehydrated. And then it also will minimize injuries and muscle cramps. So there are really good benefits to staying hydrated as a, you know, just not in the electrolyte level kind of feeling. You know, you can actually, it's almost kind of similar to massage and foam rolling that we talked about, right? So same characteristics that result in, you know, able to recover faster and less muscle cramps and possibly minimize injuries. And so the consequences of dehydration are that performance can decline. And this is a fact I got off the NCAA site here. In as little as 2 to 3% decrease in body weight from water. So just at only 2 to 3% and performance will already decrease. So that's a very minimal amount of water loss that can create a decline in your performance. It can actually create an increased core temperature and an increased heart rate, decreased blood pressure, nausea, vomiting, and then you can get general fatigue, headaches, cramps. If it's really hot out and you're dehydrated like this, it can actually lead to heat illness. And heat illness can turn into something very, very serious and very, it can actually be fatal. And so, you know, if it's super hot out and you're not hydrating, then you are going to be either needing to stop or you're just going to be in big trouble. So you should definitely, when it's hot out, make sure that there's water around, or you should just postpone practice or the game or something until you can get a better temperature. So we're going to throw up a graphic here, and we put the links on the chat so you can see these. But this is how to assess your hydration status. So the first three that we can see right now are good. So you want your urine to be very, very pale yellow. And obviously, the darker it gets, the less hydrated you are. And so we're scrolling up here. And if your urine is starting to look brown, you are in trouble. You need to be hydrating. And if you're having some of those other signs and symptoms that I talked about, the nausea and any other, dizziness, vomiting, fatigue, cramps, a really bad headache, and your urine looks like, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 on this chart here, you could be headed towards a heat illness. So I would probably advise, you can go onto the NCAA site that we have posted, and you can actually print this out, and this probably isn't a bad thing to print out and put in your practice space if you can, or put it into your little, binder kit that you keep near the medical supplies, because it's just a really good kind of rule of thumb. And I think the more people see it, then they're going to kind of look at their own urine and kind of be able to tell what they, how hydrated they are or not. I know I'm always looking at my own urine. I mean, that's what we're supposed to do. I know it sounds kind of weird, but, I'm always trying to keep...
It only sounds weird because, we're in the bodywork field. Anytime you're connected to anything, health, movement, athletic-wise, which is why a lot of our audience should be paying attention to this, you do pay attention to your stool and your urine. You just do.
Yes. Yes. And everybody should be. I mean, it's important, especially if you're an athlete. You should definitely be monitoring your hydration levels. You have any other comments about hydration?
Nope. You guys know I'll always talk, you know? I will always talk about hydration because it is important. Very yes. important. I would love for people to stay hydrated because I know what happens when you don't, because I've been there before. Once again, no judgment, just observation and knowledge.
So just a couple of little take homes. We mentioned this before, but you know, fruits and vegetables are mostly made of water. So if you're that person who's like, I don't really like water, you know, you should try to like water, but you can definitely eat fruits and vegetables to help with your hydration. And then if you are one of those salty sweaters we were talking about again, you may want to eat salty foods before the activity, drink your pickle juice. Don't be afraid to introduce a salt shaker to whatever you're doing. They also make like little kind of salt packets that you can put in your water. It's pretty harsh, but if you are a salty sweater, it's good for you. And then you can replace any of those lost salts with, you know, those salty broth-based soups. Veggie juices are really salty, so those are good. Again, if you don't really love water, smoothies, juices, sports drinks, and tea would be okay. But again, you have to be mindful of if there's sugar in them. And then also caffeine, because caffeine will dehydrate you as well. And then, you know, if I had known better, I would have thought Blue had written this line. But it says, carry a water bottle with you so you can drink water throughout the day.
So, I like to buy a fancy water bottle. Like, you know, if you're a Star Trek fan, you go ahead and get something with, like, you know, the Enterprise on it. Or if you're like a Powderpuff Girl fan, you get some Powderpuff Girls on there. You know, whatever the case may be. Like, I Love Lucy, put I Love Lucy on your bottle. It doesn't matter. Ninja Turtles kick ass. Put that on the bottle, okay? But it will make you remember to drink water. Because it's like, oh, there's my bottle. My bottle's cool. Oh, let me take a sip.
Okay? Yes.
Every time you look at that bottle and you remember something that you love, take a sip, because your body's like, hey, look over there in your, you know, passenger seat. Nobody's there, but there's your water bottle. Drink some, okay? It's helpful to have something to remember to drink water. You can put the alert on your phone. Like, I've had clients who actually put an alert for every hour. Did you drink some water? You know, you can do that. I have people who take a gallon and write each hour, you know, a motivational quote. It doesn't matter. Whatever's going to get you to hydrate, I need you to do that.
And I don't see if nothing else needs to be said except that. I think you just wrapped it up for us. That's just perfect.
That's all we got for you guys. Peoples, we will see you next week.
Sounds good. Thanks, Blue.